Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to show you four ways to round corners in Adobe Illustrator, starting with the kind of easiest, fastest way to the most involved. And then at the end, I'm going to show you a couple of cool shortcuts that you might not know to use with the corner widget tool. All right, let's get started. The first way is to select your object with the selection tool. If it's in a group like these, you're going to need to use either direct selection to select something or your group selection, which is right under here. I'll use my group selection and I'll hit A to bring up these little round corner nodes. So they look like this. Then you can just click and drag that. And if you have the whole thing selected, it will round the corners however much you want based on how far you pull. You can also use your direct selection tool to select just one corner and do that same thing. The second way is to select something and then go to Effect, Stylize, and Round Corners right here. And here you'll have to enter a radius. I'll use 10 points. And if you have preview checked, you'll be able to see what it's going to look like. I'm going to hold shift and the up arrow to increase it by quite a bit more. That looks good. So this is nice if you want to put in an actual radius. Now the thing about doing it that way, you cannot choose which corners you want rounded. It's going to round all of them. So I'm going to undo and I'll just show you quickly how to round only one corner. First, I'm going to copy this shape with Command C or Control C. Then I'll paste in front with Command F or Control F. So now I have one pink copy right on top of the other. I'll do Effect, Stylize, Round Corners, and we'll do 30. Now, because this is an appearance and one is right on top of the other, you can't see the round corner because they're both pink, but I'll just change this to a lighter pink. So now we can see what's going on. I'll go ahead and expand it with Object Expand Appearance. Then I'll use my group selection tool to just select these two shapes. And then I'll hit Shift M to get to my shape builder. And I'll hold Option or Alt to get rid of that one piece. You can also do this with Pathfinder by dividing and then just deleting that piece. I'll also unite these with Pathfinder. So I'll click this leftmost shape mode. And now we have just the one corner rounded. So it is possible to have one corner rounded, but there's a lot of extra steps. But if you have an older version of Illustrator, that might be your only option. And now I'll show you the third way. And this is another way to specify a precise corner radius. I'm going to select this blue piece with the group selection tool. So I'm going to hit A here. And then right up here, you can see corners. And I'm going to put 25 in here. And that will give us this effect. So if you have a specific number you want to put in, that is the best way. And this also works off your corner widget. So if you change this, this number will change too. Now I'm going to show you the fourth way, which is the old school way of rounding corners. This was before they had the effect of round corners in there. I'm going to hit L on my keyboard to get to the circle tool, and then I'm going to click and drag right here. With my group selection tool, I'll highlight the D and the circle. I'll hit V to get on my selection tool and click the D once. And when you have this thicker outline out here, that means you have a key object selected. So now you can align to that key object. So we're aligning the circle to the D. I want it to be flush left, horizontal align left, and vertical align top. So it probably was already there, but I wanted to make sure it's aligned along the top and to the side. Now we can just get rid of this little pink piece up here. I'll go to Pathfinder, Divide. You can also use Shape Builder for this. Then I'll get on my group selection tool and click that little piece and delete. Now I'll select the whole D. And by the way, if you're using letters like this, they have to be outlined. You would need to go to Type, Create Outlines right here if you haven't already done that. So now with this whole D selected, we can combine it back into one shape. So that first shape mode again, which is Unite. Then we can use our eyedropper to just change it back to pink. So that's four ways to round corners. Now I can also select all of these and hit A, and it will round all of them like this. So it's really nice. You can use it on more than one shape at once. Finally, I'll show you a couple of keyboard shortcuts that are very helpful. There are three types of corners. There's round corners, there's chamfer corners, and there's reverse round corners. I'm going to select this with the group selection tool, and then I'll hit A to get my widgets. I'm going to pull this in, and then I'll hit my down arrow. When I do that, it changes to the chamfer corner. This is while I'm still dragging. And then if I hit it one more time, it'll change to the reverse round. So I'll go ahead with that one. And I'll do the same with the inner one here. Select that piece, click A to get my corner widget. I'm going to pull this in, and then I'll hit my down arrow. And then release when I'm happy with it. So you can just hit the down arrow to kind of toggle through the type of corner you want. And that's it. All right, if you like this video and you want to see more videos like this, just click on the subscribe button and the little bell next to it, and you'll be notified every time a new video comes out. All right, I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.